I hope you all are doing well. Today is the 8th session of the online diplomacy course, and our topic is digital diplomacy. We have our speaker, Ms. Sadia Saif Niazi, and she is currently serving as a lecturer at the Department of International Relations and NAML, National University of Modern Languages, Islamabad. She received an MPhil degree in International Relations from National Defense University, and currently she is working on new Silk Road diplomacy, which was major exertion of her MPhil thesis. Previously, Ms. Sadia has taught international relations in different universities. She also got master's degree in history from Allama Iqbal Open University and master's degree in IR international relations from National University of Modern Languages, Islamabad. She is teaching since 13 years, and she also presented papers in different national and international conferences. She has joined Euro-Asia Studies Forum as an expert before 2 years. The floor is yours, Ms. Sadia Niazi.
Yes, assalamu alaikum and hi everyone. Today we are going to present and we are going to having a lecture on digital diplomacy. Let me share my screen. Again, today we are going to have a very important topic to be discussed. It is digital diplomacy.
Yes, ma'am.
Whenever it comes, sorry.
Yes, ma'am, we can see the screen.
Yeah, thank you. And again, today is going to be the very important topic and, you know, the very interesting topic. Whenever we have this digital diplomacy, comes the word digital, we all think, okay, just something is numerical, things are going to be happen. And in reality, nowadays, currently from the last 1 year, 2 years, when there was a COVID-19, emergence of COVID-19, we have start using and we have converted all activities on this digital diplomacy. In the outline, like if you see this picture, you can see how the world has squeezed in our hand, that how by clicking one button or by clicking the screen of your mobile, you can have access to everything, whatever you want. Today's lecture is going to be the what is digital diplomacy. In easy words, I will try to teach you that what is in easy word how you can define digital diplomacy. Then I will go to the proper definition of digital world and how, you know, several type of diplomacy is working under this digital diplomacy, in which public diplomacy is an important aspect. You people already have taken a lecture on public diplomacy. Then I will discuss historical perspective of e-meetings, then why it is important, because in current era, it is really important that we should be having known how digital diplomacy can work and how we can use it gadgets, electronic gadgets. Then I will just for the easiness and just for to be like on an easy mode, I will tell you about what kind of terminologies we can use or how the 20 digital technology can be named, and we can say, oh yeah, this comes under the digital diplomacy. Then being a student of diplomacy, being the student of international relations, like all we are gathered on this platform, we should know that what are the 5 core competencies for this tool. I will describe one by one and you will find it very interesting. And then later on in the last, as yesterday I did, different types of definitions or different types of diplomacies come under the heading of digital diplomacy. Sorry, I have written here definition is not definition, it's diplomacies come under the heading of digital diplomacy. In an easy term, if I say cyber, digital or technology, it's all come under digital diplomacy. You know, there is a cyber world is really a big world. Then digital, then technological diplomacy can cover the meaning of digital diplomacy in an easy sense. Nowadays, we are surrounded by multiple technologies and incorporating them into daily activities. This is called a digital world. And we, even the people of South, even the third world countries, we are using these all technologies nowadays, specifically from the last 2 years. The phrase digital is most commonly used in when defining digital fluency and digital literacy. The digital world is availability and use of digital tools to communicate on the internet, digital devices, smart devices, and other all technologies. As I told you, yes, if you use the word technology, if you use the word digital, if you use the word cyber, it all comes in how we can communicate through our internet technology to our devices, to our smart devices, to electronic gadgets. This is again something that how you can see the whole world is in our two hands. If you talk about your books, if you talk about your laptops, your calculator, your mobiles, your the whole world is just under your this picture. This is another picture of digital world, how the digital world has been described by the students, and they are describing the things to the students. Then your mobile, laptop, this is all the things which we can say that this comes under the digital diplomacy. Now come towards the proper definition of digital diplomacy. There are two school of thoughts in it. The first one claims that it is a new tool in conduct of public diplomacy. Other remains says that no, it is increasing the ability to interact with foreign public and actively engage with them, thereby enabling the transition from your speech, from your monologue to the dialogue. If we sum up these two school of thoughts, they says digital diplomacy is the growing use of ICTs and social media platform by country in order to achieve its foreign policy goals and practice public diplomacy. It is very much clear that diplomacy means to achieve your foreign policy objectives. So now through this digital diplomacy, by using your all electronic devices, internet devices, and by using your social media platform, either your Instagram, either you're using Twitter, you're using WhatsApp, you're using whatever the platform you're using, you are just to achieve your objectives and you are going to practice the public diplomacy. Now come towards what comes in our mind, okay, gee, how it has evolved, how it has come. And we are thinking, no, gee, the last 20 years are really crucial while doing this all digital diplomacy. But let me tell you really clear that it's not happening after COVID-19 digital diplomacy emerged. It has been emerged in 1968. In the late 1960s, there was the first video conferencing, which was introduced on the commercial solution by the World Fair in New York. The technology introduced was called the picture phone. That was the first time it has been used video conferencing. Now we are using these all video conferencing, our Zoom meetings, our internet meetings, our online classes. Either you are going to find anything like you want to learn something, you just go to the YouTube and you will learn everything. So all the Zoom line meeting, e-participation is nowadays is very common. This is just due to COVID-19 pandemic, where the diplomacy has shifted to the online conferencing platforms such as Zooms. However, online meetings are not as new as one might think. Okay, but yes, currently we are using all the things, but previously, before 2 years, we were not using it. Now comes to the important point, why it is important. It is really pertinent. It is really important. Digital technologies has advanced more rapidly than any innovation in our history. They have almost reached 50% of developing world's population in only 2 decades from the last 20 years and transforming societies. And how they are transforming societies? Through connectivity. This is an important phenomenon of current scenario as well. We used to say everything is connected today. You will learn whatever you want to learn just on one click. Then definitely we need this thing for the financial inclusion. Then we have to trade and public services. Definitely this is an important aspect that how it is important and why we use it. Digital diplomacy is using for your public services. It is using in the transportation system. It is using the trade purpose. You know very well there are smart cities in the world. Either you talk about Europe, either you talk about China. In China, there is a Incheon city, which has declared the first smart city almost 2 to 3 years back, where everything you are using that is digital. And in fact, the people who are living in Beijing, their whole data is transforming and assessing in Incheon. So the big data technology has been applied over there. In later on slides, I will teach you that how several types of terminologies has been used for the for this digital diplomacy. Then technology can be greater equalizer. Yes, digital technologies can indeed help serve the need of citizens better. This is one of the aspects that you are using for your transportation. There is no need for any money now. People used to pay from their gadgets, electronic gadgets from their mobiles. They don't pay cash. In smart cities, they don't pay cash on the counters. They just pay from their digital economy, digital currency. Then how it is serving to the mankind, they are easier access to healthcare. Yes. Now it is very much common thing that in Europe, mostly in the Scandinavian countries, Norway, Denmark, people are having a chip, small chip inside their hands. I have seen several videos. That chip is their password. Password before their homes, password for their laptops, password for everything. So, and you know, your blood pressure, your sugar, your body temperature is being monitored by your doctor all the time through that chip. So it is easier to have health care. Your financial services are digital economy is an important part. Your financial services, there is no need to have currency, paper currency all over around the world. You will have this, your internet online access to your accounts. Then important thing is your learning and create new economic opportunities for firms and individuals. Now through learning process, through YouTube, different things, either you talk about your lectures, either you talk about your cooking, either you talk about some technical knowledge about the firms, about your agriculture, you can easily learn and create economic opportunities for firms and individuals. In 2015, 2 billion people didn't have mobile phone and 60% of the world population didn't have broadband subscription. So now what the people are doing, almost in this current world, everybody is having access to their mobile phone. But never forget, the internet also enables criminal activities and pose channel to privacy and security. Digital diplomacy is very fruitful for the people, but never forget about these criminal activities, cyber insecurity. You know, cyber crimes are one of the important aspects of this non-traditional security issues. Like whatever happening, you are in the eye of someone, and also creating hurdles in your security. So never forget these things. These are some of the terminologies which we can say that how this digital diplomacy, or we can say how we can use the digital technology. When we talk about websites, when we talk about buying and selling online, when we talk about smartphone, digital television, video streaming, e-books, digital music, social media, big data technology, when we talk about this globalization process, e-commerce, online meeting, online classes, this is very common nowadays. We are all knowing about Zoom meetings. We are all knowing about this other stuff. Your transfer of money, your course, either you are looking for that digital course or either you are looking for this cooking course that is easily available. Now come towards the important aspect, that what kind of competencies, five C's, these are the five C's which we can learn, that is skill and knowledge needed by the professional. In this current world, we all are the professionals, and we must learn that what kind of five C's we are going to learn about this to use digital diplomacy. Audience, there are audience, they need five things. First, curate. Second, collaborate. Then communication. Then we will create the things, and then we have to keep in mind about the critique. Let's come to the first thing, curate. Listening is the first step. It is done by creating information and knowledge. Then if I talk about this collaboration, collaborative efforts is something while you create, you gradually start collaborating both within organization or with outside communities. You start developing your community by sharing resources, asking questions, etc. Then come towards the communication. Communication, as you know, this is the one of the important aspects of diplomacy. Regarding the communicate, it is a time to start communicating. These skills represent the ability and knowledge to extend your outreach and visibility. When you have learned these three things, come towards the fourth thing, which is really important. After collaborating and communicating, you are much more comfortable in social media, creating your online contents. This is the time now. Everybody is the writer, everybody is the producer, and everybody is the content creator. While using your social media, you are able to do these all 5 to 6 things in just a minute. But we have to learn it first, that how we can create the good and the positive narrative for your country as well, and for yourself, for your own public, for your own publicity, or for your country national interest. The last thing is critique. By now you should have gained more social visibility. This also exposes you to more critical comments and discussion. You need to engage in critical discussion and learn how to manage criticism. This is the thing. This is the most important things that you must be able to grasp the thing, that if somebody is criticizing you, then what you have to do, you have to remain calm, and you are going to remove your things which are not liked by the other one, or you will create a middle ground. So come towards the last thing, that what kind of diplomacy comes under the digital diplomacy. This was the last slide of my previous lecture as well. This is just for the clarity of the thing, that how digital diplomacy works. If we talk about social media networking, yes. Why I have written this thing in the brackets, that the besties and ambassadors, they are having their Twitter account. I am a Twitter user from the last 5 to 7 years, and from the last 2 years or 3 years, I have seen that each and every ambassador of different countries, either they belong from China, either they from Pakistan, either they're from Africa, either they're from the first world, USA and the Europe, they are starting their Twitter accounts. Now, this is really important. The embassies or the foreign offices of one country, they are pushing their ambassadors to create their accounts and to tell each and everyone what are your activities within that specific country. This is just because that this is social media networking. And this has come under the digital diplomacy. I have seen myself how China is working, how China is all over the ambassadors. They have created their Twitter accounts, and they are intimating people about what is happening over there. The same thing is happening in Pakistan. All our embassies and ambassadors, they are having their Twitter and Facebook accounts. And they just want to have inform the people that what are their activities within that specific country. The important aspect of digital diplomacy is the public diplomacy. It is in the definition of digital diplomacy as well. How this public diplomacy is working, and how a digital diplomacy can work for the public diplomacy. You have already having a proper lecture on public diplomacy. Let me come towards the diplomacy which I have written in. Then you will get to know what I was talking about. Digital diplomacy is also important for your economic gains. As in the previous lecture, I have described you that economic object to achieve your national interest, your economic objectives are always important. So what you will do, you will do the economic diplomacy to achieve your national interest. Then come towards the, when it is public diplomacy, when it's economic diplomacy, definitely culture diplomacy covers this aspect. Culture diplomacy, culture glorification, culture integration, culture imperialism, these all things come under digital diplomacy. One country, definitely when they are using their digital diplomacy, their objective is definitely public diplomacy and culture diplomacy. coming towards track one and track two diplomacy, these are the really important diplomacy, because when I talk about social media is used by the embassies and ambassador, that comes under the official representative of a state. That comes under track one diplomacy. And when I say yes, if like academicians like me and like the people or on this forum, we are the track two diplomats. We are using this digital diplomacy currently right now through our Zoom meeting. We are using this diplomacy. We are doing the public diplomacy and we are doing the digital diplomacy to achieve our objectives. Nevertheless, I think education diplomacy is very much into it, because nowadays education is through digital diplomacy. Every state, every university, every institute, every school is having their own internet facility. They are doing digital diplomacy. They are achieving objectives of education through this means. Nevertheless, trade diplomacy nowadays is really important, that you will use this digital diplomacy under this trade diplomacy, because your payments of your whatever you're buying, it's going to be your digitalized. In the conclusion, I would say that we live in a world where phrases such as digital dragons and digital icebergs are no longer an imaginary concept. These are the real things. Yes, once 20 years back, we used to say, yes, OKG, there will be digital dragons and digital icebergs, but now we are sitting on the top of those icebergs. We have become an integral part of enterprises' leaders' active vocabulary as they try to be digital tourism and try to keep up with the latest technological tools. So nowadays, we are all using latest technological tools, which are important. Gee, thank you from my side. If you have any question, you can ask me.
Thank you very much, ma'am. And it was very informative session. Thank you very much for explaining everything about digital diplomacy and about social media accounts of officials like ambassadors and diplomats. So we have a question from Lia Pomba. She would like to ask a question. Yes, Ms. Lia.
Hi, everyone. Thank you once again, Sadia, for this amazing lecture. I wanted to know, I have one question. You talk a lot about digital diplomacy and what are the type of diplomacies that come under digital diplomacy. But I still have a doubt. Digital diplomacy should be a tool. Shouldn't it be a tool used by other types of diplomacy, such as public diplomacy and economic diplomacy? I feel like digital diplomacy is only a tool that is being used by these other types of diplomacy to be included in a digital world. I don't feel like digital diplomacy is a single type of diplomacy, but I feel like it exists to be a tool to the other types of diplomacies.
Sometimes it is a That's tool, Lia Kamba. Sometimes it is a tool, and sometimes we are very much using this thing for our economic gains. Like the thing which I say, digital diplomacy, when I talk about, for example, just for your understanding, when I say that there is no need for to pay paper money, you are going to pay your money from your mobile. This is digital diplomacy, which we are doing. In this third world, we used to pay money, paper money. But when you go in Europe, when you go in the developed world, what you will find, you will pay everything with your digital gadgets. So it is very much in the use. This is just for your understanding. But if I say, think about the things like if China and Pakistan is trading, how we are paying them? Through online things. These all comes, online things come under digital diplomacy. So this is the thing which I want to tell you, that maybe it is clear to you now, that digital diplomacy, yes, it is a tool for the public diplomacy, but in reality, we are working on the same pattern by achieving our objectives, we are using this digital diplomacy.
Do we have any other question? Any other participant would like to ask?
I'm sorry, excuse me. About what Sadia just said now, the situation between China and Pakistan, shouldn't it be cultural diplomacy? We talk in economic diplomacy about the instance of, we talk about trade, commerce, and this economic diplomacy. So shouldn't it be called trade diplomacy? Instead of digital diplomacy, right. And digital diplomacy should just be a tool, right. That trade diplomacy.
What China and Pakistan are doing, we are doing economic diplomacy. It is a trade diplomacy. Agreed. But digital diplomacy is a tool that we are using current now to pay our the payments and do the other things. So in this sense, yes, it is economic diplomacy. But I said ki yes, at the same time, digital diplomacy is a tool. But sometimes it is an important aspect of your trade. So in both sense, you can take it.
So in this digital environment, you also talk about security. How do the government guarantee security in this digital trade between states? Because internet is a very dangerous space too. And we have a lot of hackers and things that affect the cybersecurity. So how do governments guarantee their security in this digital environment?
Yes, I talked about security, and I am very much, I will say your question is really right, that how the governments can give the security. Currently, like if you talk about this non-traditional security issues, if and I say, then, you know, there are cyber crimes. So internet is a very bad thing in this sense. The governments cannot give you any security because this is one of the important aspect of national non-traditional issues. We are all are thinking that how to get rid of these cyber crimes, because after digitalization and after, you know, computerizing all things, something is happening in the space. Somebody is watching you all the time through your electronic gadgets. And how you can say that you are safe? Nobody can say that we are safe. So it is really a big challenge for the governments that how they can give a security to their public. So this is one of the emerging phenomena of the world, that how they can do. But the solution which comes in my mind, that we have to create those kind of softwares which could not be hacked by the hackers. This is the only solution. But let me clear you, there are thousands of softwares are there, but unfortunately no one is there that who can not easily hack that. So it is one of the emerging issue of this, you know, this cyber insecurity.
Thank you very much. Ma'am, we have one question from Ms. Narmin Karimova. She is from Azerbaijan, and their organization, their youth organization, is working in collaboration with Youth Diplomacy Forum. So Ms. Narmin would like to ask a question.
Hi, I have a question. My name is Narmin, firstly, and thank you very much for today's session. And I have a question about digital diplomacy. What are the ways to properly manage digital diplomacy? Would you please tell me about more about it?
Can you repeat your question, please?
Okay. What are the ways to properly manage digital diplomacy?
Musaba, can you please explain your question?
Ma'am, how to manage digital diplomacy means that we are facing cyber crime issues and other problems as well. So how to manage them?
Like Narbin Kriwova, I have told you this is one of the emerging challenge. That how to manage these things. Currently, in my mind and whatever I have read so far, there is not such anything that how we can have this, you know, to have on safer side of this cyber world. So currently there is only one thing that we have to collaborate, or we have to, the world state should collaborate with each other to make it more safer, and to and they should have done an agreement that OKG, they are not going to attack the cyber thing of another country. So in this way only we can save the world. Otherwise, if I tell you that what is going on in the cyber world, how the countries and how the P5 with the UAE, how they are working on their working in space, they are doing more and more experiments all the time. They are, from the last 10 to 20 years, they are working on their cyber, they are working on this, you can say this cyber world. They are creating, or they are doing more and more experiments to have their hegemony in this cyber world. But unfortunately, the countries like ours, the country like mostly third world countries, we are unable even to go over there. Our data, our everything is in their hand. Whatever they want to, in just an easy word, whatever they want to do with us, they can easily do with us. They can hack our computers, they can hack our everything very easily. So this is one of the important issue as well, that people have now talked about, that what is happening in the cyber world, that should be limited. That should be like the country should do agreement, like whatever we have done in the NPT, non-proliferation treaty, that there will be no proliferation of nuclear weapons. So this is very much in the negotiation process. OKG, now the countries should do the negotiation, and they should not hack, or they should not infiltrate the digital world of another country. But on a realistic basis, I don't think so the countries are willing to do. They just want to have more and more hegemony over this issue, over this digitalization.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, ma'am. But we have seen this as well, that in China, like we use Facebook, Instagram, and other applications. So in China, they do not use these applications. They have their own applications, which are used by Chinese people. So China is somehow following their own path. So I mean, if something happens, or somehow, if someone hacks Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram, this will affect us. This will affect people of Pakistan and other third world countries. But this is not going to affect Chinese people, because they are using their own devices, they are using their own applications. So this is what other countries can also...
Musawir, just make me one thing clear, that although they are using their own devices, their softwares, but those are also a part of this digital world. Never forget, whatever they are using, that can be easily hacked by some other country. Make one thing clear, all thing is a digital diplomacy, but your digitalization process, your computers can easily be hacked by someone else. This was the thing I want to tell you.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you very much for explaining. Do we have any other participant to ask a question? Yes, Mr. Osvaldo, please.
Yes, ma'am. I'm sorry. I'm going to be very quick. I can see people are just asking a lot of questions, and I know how, it feels, but you have to be strong, because the more questions, the more we understand exactly what was this topic about. Well, my question is something I'm just curious. I don't know if it's a proper question, but I'm just very curious about this, because I've done network marketing before. I've worked in a network marketing company, and I would like to know if there is any relationship between network marketing and what was that, and digital diplomacy, or to be more specific, any relationship between networking and digital diplomacy, like
Mr. Zhao, it is really it is correlated. There is not a single difference with the digital diplomacy and networking is the same as digital diplomacy. Whatever you are doing on computer, whatever you are doing networking all around the world, these all things are digitalized. Those are very much part of each other.
Yeah, it's okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Do we have any other question? If not, then we end up our meeting. So thank you very much, Ms. Sadia, for your fruitful presentation and for very informative discussion with the participants as well. And thank you for explaining everything about digital diplomacy, because of COVID-19, now everyone is using these digital platforms like we are using right now, and like Zoom and other applications. So this is a need of time right now. So we have to follow this. So digital diplomacy is very important in today's world. And thank you very much for explaining us. And thank you very much to all the participants for joining. We are ending up our session here and see you soon. Thank you very much. Good luck.